Hello, welcome to Bodice Fashion Academy YouTube channel. Today, we will be adapting the basic dartless bodice to a kimono pattern. As always, this tutorial is a beginner-friendly tutorial. Please like, comment, and subscribe to this YouTube channel. You can also press the notification button below so that you will be notified of any tutorial that comes onto this channel. So before we go into the class, you can also contact us on Instagram at Bodice Fashion Academy, on Facebook at Bodice Fashion Academy. Without further ado, let's go right into the tutorial. Thank you for joining in. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Welcome back. So today we'll be adapting this our basic dartless bodice pattern into a kimono dress. I don't want you to get me wrong. This dartless basic bodice dartless pattern will be used to cut a sheet dress, which will be patterning with our Ankara patches. So I just thought that I could also teach us how to adapt these basic bodies into a kimono dress. So that means we'll be doing two projects for this class. So as you can see, this is the dartless bodies we drafted earlier on. This is the back and this is the front. So we'll be using this pattern to cut our shift dress that will be patched with Ankara patches. Then now what we'll be doing in this present class that we are in now is that we'll be adapting these patterns into a kimono dress. So I hope you get value at the end of this class. So the first thing we'll be doing is that I don't know if we know what a kimono dress looks like. A kimono dress is a dress that is cut together at the shoulder. It is cut together at the shoulder. Sometimes you can make a seam on the shoulder. Sometimes you don't make a seam at all. It depends on your taste. Here is a diagram of what a kimono dress looks like. We are just going to cut out the neck. Sometimes we use it to make bubu captains, and if you know the regular Yoruba that Yorubas make, that is what we cut together with the sleeve. That's what a kimono bodice basically is. So what we'll be doing now is, I said earlier, is that we'll be adapting our basic dartless bodice to a kimono. So I'll be using the front pattern for this class, the front pattern of our dartless bodies. That's what I'll be using for this class. So the first thing I'll do is to secure my pattern with a masking tape so that it won't move while I'm adapting this pattern. So I'm securing my, let me know this my paper, let me. So I'm securing my pattern with a masking tape so that the pattern won't move while I'm adapting this particular pattern. So I think it's okay, that's it. So the first thing I'll do is that I'll trace out the neck of this pattern. Like, I want this neck is 3x3 and I want my kimono pattern to be same. So this is a 3x3 neck. If I don't want it, I can change. It depends on my preference. So in case maybe you want just a very high neck, some people would like their kimono to be a natural neckline. Like, so there's a particular kimono I made for a client recently. We made the neck of the kimono a natural neckline. It was up on our neck, so we just knitted the front a little and fixed a little button on the neck, so whenever she wears it, she uses a silver brooch to beautify
the neck of the dress. So it depends on what you want for the dress. So like I said, I think this neckline is okay. So I'm going to be tracing this neckline out. This neckline is okay. So I'm tracing the shoulder out too. This is a very simple procedure. So I've traced the neck and the shoulder part out. So I'm going to be extending this shoulder because I'm cutting together with this sleeve. So I'm going to be extending this shoulder. So what I'm doing is that can you see how I placed my ruler? The ruler is slanted, it's following the slant of the shoulder. I'm not placing it straight this way. I'm going to I haven't actually measured what I want for this sleeve. Now I'm going to be making the sleeve out of this pattern. So let's just say I want something around 6 inches. So here is my tape measure. I want something around 6 inches. So I'll be stopping here. So I'll follow the slant to where my 6 inches gets to. So that's all for that shoulder part. Then, you know, a kimono is not a shaped dress. It's not a shaped dress, it shifts a lot on the body and it has a lot of space in it. It now depends on your preference. You can make the space wider or very wide, a little bit wide, depends on your preference. So for this shift dress, I don't want too much space. So I'm just going to like add 1 inch to this pattern. This is the exact waist of our client. So I'm just going to add 1 inch Actually, I might not even follow the shape of this allowance I'm adding. What I'm doing is that I just want to create a straight line out of this. Can you see what I'm doing? I'm bypassing the 1 inch I marked on the waist. You can also follow this shape. Let me just go this way. You can do it this way, or if you want a little bit of ease, you can just from the hip here just draw a straight line. Like I said, it depends on your taste. So you can see that this has more space, look at it, and this has little space. It depends on what you want. Now to get the sleeve, so what we are going to do here, it's just that we are going to, can you see what I did? This is okay, since it has met this edge, so we are going to follow this line. Our kimono pattern is ready. Can you picture something out of this? So what we just do is that we are going to be using this pattern to cross the front and back. Is very easy, very very easy. So like I said, it depends on you. You can use this straight line and come this way. Look at the amount of space we have here. Like if I measure it here on the waist, like we have extra 3 inch ease. But for this one, we have just 1 inch. So it depends on what you want. So it's either you go with this or you go with the shaped one, though it also has a little bit of shape. Like because of my stature, I don't like wearing something big. So if it's for me, I'll prefer this. But most times what I do is that if I'm doing it this way, I might not make it curved. Sometimes I make it curved. It depends on whatever I want. But like we have done here now, you have an idea of what this looks like. So what you do at the end is that you just add your sewing allowance for the hem. you know, you are going to hem the dress. So it depends on what you want. If you want 1 inch, you add your 1 inch sewing allowance to hem the dress. So let me add 1 inch here. So just add the 1 inch allowance to hem this dress. So we'll be cutting this out now, and you see that this is so easy. Cutting this out now to see that we have our kimono pattern ready. Thank you.